We have had three consecutive years in a row with an on-time state budget, and I think the governor set the right tone in his budget presentation, that I'm optimistic that we'll have a fourth budget in a row that'll be on time and meet the needs of the people of the state. I particularly like the governor's emphasis on tax cuts. Utilizing the projected $2 billion budget surplus in a way that is returned back to the taxpayers in the form of property tax relief and also other measures that will help spur our economic development and job creation with tax cuts for our business community and employers. I think it's very, very important that we make the state a more affordable place to live through property tax relief and a more attractive place to do business through business tax cuts. I like the presentation and emphasis on education that I heard in the governor's presentation. The fact is, however, we have a lot of work to do further in the area of budget work on the state aid for education portion. The governor had talked about some new initiatives in education in the pre-K, pre-kindergarten, as well as after-school programs. Those are great. Who can argue with those? But yet, we do not adequately fund what's in place now in our school districts. And here he's talking about spending money on new initiatives. So somehow we have to strike the right balance there. Provide our school districts, many of which are really financially strained, helping them further with state aid education, but also coming in with important programs like pre-kindergarten and after-school programs. I really like the fact the governor is going to create a special panel to review the implementation of the Common Core curriculum in our school districts. This is a ray of hope for many of us who have been very, very concerned about the way that the Board of Regents and the State Ed Department have been implementing this Common Core, causing a lot of problems in our school districts. And with this special panel on Common Core, I'm hoping that we can step back, hit that pause button, and let's reassess exactly where we're going and how we're doing it in terms of the Common Core. No one can argue with higher standards or having our kids achieve more in the classroom, but let's take the time to get it right. I'm hoping that the next few weeks we'll be able to come in with additional details as we negotiate a new state budget that will once again be on time and meet the needs of the people of the state.